right.
He's taking every wall.
Honored Rabbonim, community leaders, family, and friends, ladies and gentlemen, we do not have a program of speeches this evening. However, the mechutanim of this evening's simcha wish to take a few moments to greet their guests and to extend their blessings and prayers to all of you, and especially to their children, Shmaya and Rivka. In a moment, I'm going to introduce to you Rabbi Yosef Yitzchak HaKohen Gutnick. He is a person who possesses the unique ability to combine the proverbial chesed of Avraham, as expounded in the Midrash, and the pure love of Aaron HaKohen, as explained in the Mishnah. Haveni talmidav shel Aaron, ayeves abriyas mekarv on the Torah. For through his love and through his chesed, he brings thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands close to Torah, and especially close to the teachings of Torah and Chassidus of the Lubavitcher Rebbe Shlita, for whom we all pray that the Almighty bestow upon him immediate and a miraculous recovery. Many people who are here this evening have come for varying reasons, but there is a common denominator to give homage and respect to this very special family, to Rabbi Joseph Gutnick and to his wife Stera, and to the young couple who will carry on their tradition. The cliche in Ve'agefen, but in Ve'agefen perhaps has become hackneyed. But if we look to the Gemara, Psachim Daf Memtes, we find that the Gemara discusses the question of marriage and uses the term of Inve Agefen, Be Inve Agefen, when it speaks of a Kohen who marries a Bas Kohen. or, as in our case this evening, a bas kohen who marries a young man who, although he may not be a kohen, is a Talmud Chacham from a family of Torah and Chassidus. Then the Chachamim tell us that this is truly inveya gefen, for this is the marriage of the rich vines, and the blessing will continue with this young couple, so that they will bear the most beautiful fruits in the coming generations. Ladies and gentlemen, decades from now, those of us who are here this evening will tell our grandchildren that we were at the great chasana, that great wedding of the Gutnick family and the Krinsky family. It gives me great honor and a great privilege to introduce to you now, and I request once again that everyone refrain from speaking and from any other form of making noise, and please give your undivided, complete attention and absolute silence to the mechutin this evening, to a person whose reputation goes before him, and I need not add anything more to what I have said, Harav Yosef Yitzchak HaKohen Gutnick. Ladies and gentlemen.
On behalf of my wife and myself, I would like to thank you all for making a special effort to join us at our simcha. An extra special thanks to all family and friends who have traveled from afar, Australia, Israel, South America, South Africa, Europe, and various cities of the United States and Canada. With the help of the Almighty, may we all participate at many, many more Simchas Tadeva, Gesundheit und Freilichkeit. 4th on our minds is the well-being of our Rabbi Shlita. We pray to God that the Rabbi Shlita should have a miraculous and immediate recovery. Our simcha is not complete and cannot be complete without the Rabbi Shlita fully back to health again. In Tilling, Psalms we recite, Im eshkochech Yerushalayim tishkach yemini. If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand lose its cunning. Im lo yeleh Yerushalayim al reis simchasi. If I will not bring to mind Jerusalem during my greatest joy. We think of the holy city Jerusalem and our holy land at the time of our simcha, with fervent prayers for a true peace based on Shlemus Haaretz, a greater Israel, no concessions or humbling ourselves to our enemies. Only an uncompromising, strong Israel will bring true peace to Israel and the world. Hatev ki lo cholorach amecha, v'amrachem ki lo samu chasodecha, ki me'elom kivinu loch. You are the source of God, good, for your mercies never cease. You are the merciful one, for your kindness never ends, for we always place our hope in you. Kotenti mikol achasodim mikol emes asher osiso es avdecha. I am unworthy of all the kindness and faith that you have shown me. The Alter Rebbe, Reb Shneur Zalman of Liadi, founder of the Lubavitch movement, on his miraculous release from imprisonment nearly 200 years ago in Tsarist Russia, quoted this verse of our forefather Jacob in his famous holy letter Kotenti, and he stated there, Shekol chesed vechesed shakodish boruchu eisa lo adam sorach li yeshval ruach ma'ed. Every single kindness that God bestows on man should bring humility and humbleness. The Almighty has bestowed his kindness and goodness upon us, and our hearts are filled with gratitude and praise. We have been blessed with a beautiful family, grandparents, parents, brothers, sisters, brothers-in-law, sisters-in-law, uncles, aunties, and cousins of the highest distinction. Unfortunately, my mother, Zichrona Livracha, is not with us here tonight, but Gashmius. Although Beruchni is spiritually, she is certainly here. Jewish tradition teaches us that the souls of departed parents and grandparents are present at a family simcha. We thank Hashem for the chesed of having spent so many years together with her. We really miss her here tonight. God has blessed our family with wealth. The Rabbi Shlita has given me encouragement in the pursuit of treasures down under. Vast amounts of gold, thank God, have been discovered already by our company. We will spare no effort in our search also for diamonds, in fulfillment of our Rabbi's prophecy. I seek God's providence, so that I may be a good agent to sanctify the name of God in Lubavitch. God has also blessed us with Bliya and Horeb, wonderful children. Tonight is Rivka's night. She is a good-natured, clever, beautiful daughter. My darling Rivka has been an outspoken, staunch supporter of mine during many controversial communal situations in the past. I'm very grateful for her support and look forward to Shemaya joining the ranks. The greatest chesed of all, a chesed achi godel, that God has granted us, has been the close relationship our family has had with the Rabbi Shlita. This relationship and closeness we will continue to treasure forever. I am honored to have come to know my mechutonim, Rabbi and Mrs. Krinsky, over the last number of months. Our relationship really began more than 5 years ago, when Yudel and myself both merited to have a personal audience together with the Rabbi Shlita at his home in President Street. Yudel, I hope that I can assist you in your mammoth responsibility, preserving the dignity of the Rabbi Shlita and the Lubavitch movement worldwide. You are not only gaining a new mechutin tonight, but I hope a loyal friend. We are confident, my wife and myself, and my wife said that if I say anything about it tonight, I'll ruin the simcha. So therefore, really, anything said about my wife is superfluous. Anyone who knows her, nothing has to be said. She speaks for herself. We are confident, my wife and myself, that the Chosin and Kala will build a true Jewish Chassidisha home in the spirit of both our families to sanctify God's name and the holy work of our Rabbi Shlita. Thank you again, all of you, for attending our Simcha. May we spend our next Simcha all together, Yerushalayim in our Kiddush, together with the Rabbi Shlita. Thank you.
And it is truly a great honor for me this evening to introduce to you this very unique individual, a person who has truly been Korev L'Malchus and has been Meshamesh B'Kodesh these 40 years to our dear Rebbe Shlita. Oise Laila Kayoyim, 24 hours a day on call, ready, able, and willing, and devoted to his Rebbe and to our Rebbe. And ladies and gentlemen, I must add that he too, in his own way, followed the teachings of Aaron HaKohen. For he too showed that Ava L'Briyos, and he too was Mekarev on the Torah in his various roles, in the various organizations of Chinuch, of Lubavitch, in Merkez, in Maskiros, and so on. He reached out to tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of Jews all over the world and brought them closer to Yiddishkeit and to the teachings of Torah and Chassidus of the Rebbe Shlita. Rabbi Krinsky has truly been the spokesman for the international Lubavitch movement. As a leader of the Shluchim who have spread out all over the world, one who has his finger on the pulse of whatever is going on in all corners of the world. For it is to him that the Shluchim come back for guidance and for direction, for inspiration, and for connection to Beis Chayenu, to the Rebbe Shlita. For in truth, in his many areas of service to the Rebbe and to Lubavitch, he has truly been a confidant of the Rebbe. And now, in these difficult and trying times, he is at the helm of those select people who are devoting their days and their nights, their very lives and every moment of their existence in caring for the Rebbe Shlita in his illness, and in gathering together those forces which will eventually, very speedily, very soon, immediately bring healing in the fullest sense and in the most miraculous way to our Rebbe. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the great privilege to introduce to you tonight the mechutn this evening, Rabbi Yehuda Krinsky. Please.
Shalom be'agam chen ha'hespet. Can you hear me? Ich sag zu ganz schöne Hespet, ihr Herr.
Go close, go close.
Close enough? Ich sag zu ganz schöne Hespet, ihr Herr. Ich will umfangen und um Messiah sein mit Lachaim. Lachaim. I want to say a few words in Yiddish and then a few more in English, but I assure you that I will be brief. Ich will zum aktuellen Märchen wünschen, mir kenne Wisch, mir leibe um mich, ein herzlichen Mantel, zu hoffen Kalle, zu schmein, Rivke soll gesund sein, und die Kinder, die Ebesche soll sie wünschen, als alle Brüche, was der Rebbe soll gesund sein, hat sie gewünschen, und wünscht sie, und wird sie wünschen, soll es kein werden, die Milua, und alle Brüche, was Tate Mama wünschen, Wir beseiden wünschen, Bruder, Schwester, Mischpoche, ein guter Freund, soll man kümmern werden, auch mit Ruhe. Im Leale, alle ist zum Chossi. Ich gedenke, von Zeit zu Zeit, ich habe sich vergreden mit den Rebbe, Aleh Shalom Zal. Befrat Erev Rosh Hashanah and Erev Yom Kippur. Man fragt sich unwünschen, mit Kohl zu. Fragt sie sagen, als sie, wir wissen nicht, was sie wünschen sie. Es soll der Eberstimme mal sein, das, was man der wünscht sich nicht. Es soll der Eberste helfen, als sie ungebenscht werden, der Chosen Kalle, mit Eishir, mit Anayin, und Eishir mit Analef, mit Kohl, Tuv, Gashmi, Beruchni, in alle Broches, mit der Rebbe's Rogel zu sagen, von, was fängt sich an, von alle Eishis, von alle Beis, von alle Pistoch. Und noch mehr. Ich gedenke, sei ich ein junger Bocher, ich bin ein Vatochen Jud, ich bin ein Verhassener. Und der Rebbe soll gesund sein, der dort gerät. Ich habe jemals nicht verstanden, was der Rebbe gerät. Und ich verstehe heute Technik, was der Rebbe soll gesund sein, was gerät. Aber er hat gebracht, der Mund, was er steht, als Hai Alme, gebe ich die Lula Damie, da als Linon Mine. Und der Rebbe soll gesund sein, dass es auch geteilt, da als Linon Mine, als mir wird von dem Amahalle. Und wie gesagt, ich habe jemals nicht verstanden, was das meint, ich verstehe eigentlich nicht, was das meint. Nur zufällig, ich kann sagen, das Wort zufällig, ist da ein Hemmschicht von Rebisch Moseiden, was ruft sich an Samach zu Samach, von Tofreschen und Seien, was wir gesagt haben, auf der Hassene von der Friedrich Rebbe, was er gewinnt hat, Ben Jochid, bei der Rebbe Rashab. Und so meinen wir, ein Hemmschicht, was der Rebbe soll gesund sein, hat geheißen, mit Mann und Mann soll uns lernen, mit Käse, mit Chassenes von Kindern. Und dort wird gebracht, die Icke von dem Hemmschicht, durch sagt mir, ist wegen dem Ingen von Simcha, in was der Ingen von der Chassene bedeiht, und dem Gede von Simcha bekäschen zu der Chassene von der Kind. Dort wird gebracht, als er durch verschiedene Yehudim in Sivugi in Lamailo und Scheiche zu sagen. Und es wird gebracht, als er durch Yehudim von Malochim in der Sicher davor. Von dem kommt kein Sach nicht der Ruiz Papel. Was er ruchen ist, dicke Yehud, mit ruchen ist, dicke Uftuach, und es hat nicht kein Scheiche zu Papel. Was er ein Kind, die Yehud von Zun, wo das der Scheiche zu Nishom ist, in das Scheiches Lepel. In das wird uns der Rebbe, das ist die Linie von Achassene. Was bei ihm ist, Malochim, seien doch Eindem. Chai Hashem, Chai Hawaii, Lekei Yisrael, Hashem, Mada, Telefono. Und Neshomes, wenn angerufen, Mehalchim. Ist eine Linie von Neshomes, von dem Yichud Zun, wo das wird aufgetan bei Achassene, wo das der Scheiches in Yonim, wo haben sich Neshomes Bepel, ist das eine Linie von Mehalch. Ich weiß nicht, man kann sagen, dass das ist ein Bier und die Adelinen mir nicht. Aber bei allen Ebenen lernen die dem Hemmschicht, und bei dem Mann, auf dem Wort von Reben, auf der Chassene, als Hai Almut, die bei Eluli, damit die Adelinen mir nicht. Es steht doch in Tanja, wird gebracht von Seha, als er dort der Linien von Chet, wird Kieh, Bliboi, Mesitra, da, und bei Chet, Kieh, Bliboi, Mesitra, da. Das heißt, als er dort zwei Chalokim im Leib, was eine kann sein zum Meach und eine ist Bebechir. Leider gefühlen wir sich in der Masse, was der Bechir ist nicht in der halben Leib, nur das vernimmt im ganzen Leib. Das lassen wir zu, kein Simcha Schleimo. Und wir beten beim Ewigsten, dass der Ewigste soll bringen, dass der Simcha sein Beschleimus und soll sein vom Wasser sein bei Simcha. Ich will beten, dass Chosin mit Kalle belieben, soll Menschen dem Reben mit der Erfuhr Schleimus kreben. So da hat sie für die Meise nicht lang zurückgesehen, als in der Tag von der Chassin von Reben Marash mit Harabonis Rizke, was loschen nefel ala loschen, dass der Name von Heintike Kalle soll gesund sein, ist der Schwer, in der Zemach Zedek hat er reingerufen und hat gebeten, dass er sie soll ein Mensch. Ist doch ein Sinn, als ein Kalle, als Schnur, kein Mensch, als Schwer, als Rebbe. Und sie hat jemand geämpft, sie ist doch gewöhnt, sehr akkluge, hat sie geämpft, gesagt, sie ist gewöhnt von Zemach Zedek, und sie hat gesagt, auch wenn sie Zemach Zedek, als hier, wird das Kalo, hätte ich mir ihn. Wir mehr hoffen, wir alle zusammen, und betreten sie, dass wir Kalo, wir wünschen dem Rebbe, als Rebbe soll hoffen, als Refur, Schleim und Rebbe, teken wir wie ein Mammisch. Und der Rebbe soll gesund sein, soll sich umstellen auf das Fies, nicht so melden. Und er soll uns umstehen, er soll uns geben Brokkes, er soll uns zählen der Laden, er soll tun mit uns, was er will. Und mir soll das zu ist, nahe zu mir nicht mehr. Aber wie mir soll das sein, bei einigen Brokkes, denke ich um die Jahre. Als eben dem Kunden des Frieden Mann erwarnt, als der Eberstadt sich gewünscht, deine Sprache mit Aschirus, und er denkt der Mann, als der Kalle ist der Kluge. Das ist das, was wir wissen, was wir wissen. Interessant ist, ich habe nicht nur ein Gesehen, das kennt es allein der Kupto, aber es ist Chayel, nie ihm so, sagt der Ebenezer, was meint Chayel, das meint der Moment und der Kupto. Er sieht, man fragt, ey, das Scheile von mir ihm so, ist das Scheile, was man darf auf dem Entfernen hat. Is the third is Schmeier. Er hat gefunden, der Mensch ist Keil, aber was auch immer der Meinung ist, was der Ebenezer lebt durch und versteht er noch als Sache, als Sache, mehr Breite und Ziffere Meinung. So der Ebenste sind Menschen mit Kohl, Tug, Gashmi, Berufni, Besöge, Schor, mit Vero und alle, wie Friege, sagt alle Prophets, was man wünscht, sollen wir kuhn werden, auch mit Wursch. Just a few words in English. Again, a heartfelt mazel tov to the Chosn Kala, to my wife, to our new Choshev Mechutonim Yossi, Gutnick and Mrs. Gutnick, to the father of Chaim Zolgazun Zayn, to Erich Yom Hashem Tevis, to his Shred and Shvigin Mendelin, new and his wife, and my Shred and Shvigin Zolgazun Zayn, to Erich Yom Hashem Tevis, to the love of Masach, Yiddish, and Siddish, and Achash, for nun Zalman. I just want to say a word about my son. Not about my son so much as about his namesake, namely my father,
my Choshev and Mechut mentioned before that to Achasene are invited and attend previous generations. And they attend in a spiritual way, but they are here with us. My father, Oliver Sholem, Zal came to this country little after the turn of the century. He was a young orphan, alone, destitute, and penniless. He settled in the town of Plymouth on Cape Cod, a typical New England town. Alone, as said. But this young orphan was a very, very determined man. And his determination was that he was going to live as a Jew, as he remembered from home. He would not be influenced by the winds of change blowing in the New World, where the streets were allegedly paved with gold. And God helped him, and he found a woman like him who lived in a farm in a small town called Auburn, near Worcester, Massachusetts. And they married. And the determination was fulfilled. Despite all odds, they built a home, as the Rebbe wished the Chosn and Kala today, on the foundations of Torah and mitzvot. And in the course of their lives, they succeeded in bearing 9 children, of which I happen to be the youngest. I am pleased to say that tonight at this glorious chasana, all 9 children are here together. Velvel, my oldest brother, who according to Torah, it is incumbent upon me to bestow special kovod, and his wife Rhoda have come specially for this occasion from Melbourne, Australia, the land of our mechutanim. My brother Meisha came from Petach Tikva. My brothers Yosef from Brooklyn and Pinchas from Boston. My sister Ruth from New Haven, Evie and Sophie from Chicago, and Yochi from Boston. You don't know how glad I am and Dvorah is for your being here with us tonight. It adds a special luster to today's simcha. And these nine children bore my parents hundreds of blessed Einiklach and Ur Einiklach that we hesitate to count. And these children and grandchildren are scattered around the globe, but not scattered in the sense of being lonely. Most of them are shluchim of the Rebbe and accomplished much in their lives in helping others. And this came from a Jew and a Jewess who were alone and penniless just a little less than a century ago. But the determination that they had brought them God's blessing and the bounty that they now reap. It has always been a philosophical wrestling in my mind, which is harder, to live in a country of oppression under a communist or a Bolshevik regime where religion is suppressed and to remain a Jew in the full sense of the word? Or is it more difficult to do so in a land of freedom, where the temptations are greater and the winds of change have an effect on the environment and on the community and on the individual? I've never been able to decipher, to discern, which is the greater test of faith. But I'm pleased to say that Shemaya, my dad and my mother, withstood that test of faith. And Shemaya and Rivka now in their lives have led exemplary lives. All those who know them know that that's the case. They, thank God, did not have this test of faith that our parents had. And we hope and pray that as the mashal of the dwarf upon the shoulders of the giant, they have so much to look back upon, so much strength that gives them fortitude and the ability to withstand all the temptations and all the winds that they may encounter in their future lives. They have the strength inherent in their blood, and we are confident and we know that as the Rebbe writes in his letter, that Yivnu Bayis Neman B'Yisrael Al Yoseidei HaTeira V'HaMitzvah Kivi Shehem Mu'orim B'Moshe V'Teira Zuhi Teiras HaChasidus, we know that that will be fulfilled in its completion. We thank you all for coming from near and from far. May God grant each and every one of you, all of you who have blessed us, and the Chosen Kala, Kol HaMavorech Mizborech, may you all be blessed in abundance with God blessings materially and spiritually. May you see nachas from your children, from your grandchildren, and may we be able, Dvor and myself and the Chosen Kala and I'm sure our mechutonim, to pay you back on happy occasions and simchas in your lives. Thank you very much. L'chaim, l'chaim, l'chaim l'chaim.
please come up to the dais.
Go for it, Morty.
Samach to Samach, Samach, Yitzirich, Obegan, Eidem, Mekadem, Oratani, Noi, Nasere, Achoson, Bechalom.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam Asher bara sasa v'simcha sasa v'chala Yilorin aditza v'chenlo Ahavu v'yachavu shalom v'reyus Me'ayir Adonai Eloheinu Yishoma v'yare yoda V'chutza Yerushalayim
Thank you, Lubbovich Orchestra.